They ask me all the time, you know, when are we going to be able to go back out and play?
Her main concern is, when are we going to be back at school?
When will it be safe to get a haircut, go out to eat, or work without fear of catching the virus? Epidemiologists use modeling to predict when and where COVID-19 might hit hardest, and how many new infections and fatalities are likely.
It allows us to take sort of what we know at a very small scale about how infection spreads, and then to scale it up to ask questions that really have sort of like cultural and political and real personal relevance.
But search the internet and you'll find confusion and conflicting public opinion, with some people questioning whether the original numbers were overestimated or inflated for political reasons, and whether social distancing is an overreaction. Kistler says, not so fast. Models are meant to change. Every place that closed, every donned mask, and person who self-isolated played a part in predicting outcomes.
People have really changed their behavior, and that can really change the way that the disease spreads. And so that can completely change the model because, again, those underlying assumptions that we put in from the beginning have changed.
Scientists studying the virus in 194 places worldwide found social distancing played a critical role in keeping the virus from overwhelming health systems. Kistler says it will take additional surveillance to help control the U.S. spread.
We're still learning a lot about this infection. There's still a lot of data coming in. Our projections can change over time, and ideally they're getting better and better as we're learning more.
I'm Jessica Sanchez reporting.